Okay, so now that we've set up how the email sends out to users when they book an appointment, I'm going to show you what they will see if they decide to use the link at the end of their email and cancel that appointment. So we're going to click on this cancellation tab. And you can see this is what the text looks like that I've entered. Yours might look different. It will probably say you are about to cancel the following appointment, or excuse me, following booking. Because I've used appointment throughout, I'm going to continue to use appointment rather than booking. And it's going to give them the time then, the date and time. You may also have an option of reasons why they're canceling and a text box displayed. I've unchecked the box to display that text box, and I've not required a reason for cancellation. It doesn't matter to me. If they need to cancel, I'd rather have them cancel than just not show up. So once I make changes here, you will see that those changes are reflected on this preview down at the bottom half of my page. You may also want to check out the Reminders tab if you want to set up reminders for yourself or reminders for other people. Now, reminders for other people, especially in email form, are a premium feature that you'd have to pay for, but you can see here that I can set up a Google reminder for myself since it's linked with my calendar. It will send me an email 10 minutes before the appointment. If I wanted to, I could add another reminder and have a text message sent or a pop-up message sent from my calendar. You'll notice if I look at email here, this is email for others, and as you can see, it's a premium level feature. But if you wanted to try, you could set it up so that users who book appointments can get an SMS or a text reminder to their phone. This might be an ideal feature that we could try out with a smaller group like with a medical school. And then finally, I want to just identify the appearance tab, which is where you can change how things look. So you could put a header or a footer at the top or bottom of your page if you wanted to include text on your page. You can pick a theme. You can see I've picked this one. I thought it had kind of an OU vibe, but you could pick any of these other options as well that look a little bit different. So if I changed it to classic, for instance, eventually here it's going to be reflected. And we can see what it looks like, slowly but surely. This one looks a lot much simpler, smaller. But I could also change the colors, change the fonts. But really, sometimes it's just easiest to pick a theme and stick with it.